Hi, this is Trub from Marquee Insights, and today we're going to show you a new and updated video on a very popular topic on our blog, how to mine data out of your SharePoint list using Power BI. So what follows is an updated video using the September 2023 version of Power BI Desktop, and we're going to be using the Issues Tracker List template from SharePoint, and we're going to show you how to connect to it, how to get the data out of it, and some tips and tricks that you might want to take advantage of to make sure you've got great performance and that you've got the data that you need. Stay tuned.
We are going to start the process with the Issue Tracker template that's built into Microsoft Lists. As you can see, it has a lot of the common situations you find querying data from SharePoint. For example, we have a person field. How do you resolve this information? We have a status field, which is a lookup. How do we get this information from within Power BI? The first thing we're going to do is go to Power BI Desktop and connect to the list. On the Home tab in the ribbon, select Get Data. Since SharePoint isn't in the initial list, select More. Enter the search term Share. You could type SharePoint, but Share is usually enough, and you'll notice there's three options here. Since we are getting data from Office 365, we select the middle one for SharePoint Online List. The SharePoint List option is only for on-premises. Now we click Connect. I've already gotten the site URL, and this is an important point. Many will attempt to use the list URL, but this will lead to an error. I paste in the site URL, and here you'll see it. For this part of the demonstration, I'm showing you the 1.0 implementation. I will do a second version of this where we do the 2.0 implementation, and I'll highlight the difference between the two. Personal preference is that the 1.0 implementation has richer data. Now click OK and we will get prompted then to log into the data source. Some of you may have IT restrictions that limit your interactions here. We've seen comments on previous video of people who were not able to switch the selection. If that's the case, you need to talk to your IT team. Typically, you will select Microsoft account. Power BI defaults to anonymous access, which is used if you are connecting to a public internet site. Windows is used for on-premises SharePoint instances for which you would need to connect to a gateway. We want Microsoft account. First, you should select this drop-down to select the site that you're connecting to. Otherwise, you could get an error because you may not have root site access. Secondly, you'll click Sign In and you may get prompted for your login if you connect to multiple tenants. So I'm selecting my login credentials. Now it shows I'm currently signed in. I can go ahead and click Connect. You'll see it reading the information from the website. And now what I will get is a picker that allows me to select one or more lists. We will look for our issues list, which is here. If I click on the name, I will see a preview on the right to ensure that I've got the right selection. Issue tracker looks to be correct. I'll check the box next to it. And now I want to click the transform data button, not the load button. The reason is that there's a couple of things that we need to correct in the data to make it usable, because of the way Power Query works with SharePoint. Click Transform Data. This will bring up the Power Query Editor. We'll start with filters. If you need to filter the data for any reason, you want to do that first. For example, for this reporting, I need to filter out all low priority records. So, I'll add a text filter for does not equal and a value of low, for example. The reason for doing filtering first is a performance tip related to a process called query folding. If you do your filters first, they will fold and be run in SharePoint instead of Power BI. You'll get only the resulting records, instead of the entire list where it'll filter it down in Power Query. Secondly, we'll set the data type of our columns. Data type drives what actions you can take in Power Query, so it's important to set your types. You'll notice the icon in the upper left-hand corner of every column, where here it shows ABC 123. This is Power BI's version of saying, I don't know what this is. If you go to the Transform tab, you will see it says Data Type Any. You can click the icon and set the data type for every column, but this would be very time consuming. Instead, let's set the data type for all columns at once. Click to select our first column, then scroll to the right until you see a column that contains the word record or table in it, and these values are in green text. Don't select those green text columns. Instead, shift-click the last column before the green text columns, like you do in Excel. Now go to the Transform tab in the ribbon and select Detect Data Type. Power Query reads the first 25 records of each column to determine the column's data type. It's not always 100% correct, but it's much faster than setting the data type one by one. Also, if all the records are null, it's not going to be able to set the data type, which we see here in issue log by string ID. It'll remain ABC123. As you scroll through, you'll see the columns have icons, like this column now has a date icon. One thing you'll notice is that on the web, the assigned to column had a name, but here the assigned to column had an ID number representing the internal user ID. There's an easy way to get to this name. One reason we didn't select the green text earlier is that those are special expandable columns. When expanded, they execute subqueries to retrieve extended data like names. There is one special column called Field Values as Text that contains most of the extended values in one place. To see what data is available, don't click on the record itself. Instead, click to the right of it to open the preview pane. Drag to extend the pane upward, and you can see all this wonderful information that's stored in the extended column. Here is the assigned to name. To expand the column, click the double-headed arrow icon at the top right. The drop-down will load all of those columns. If there are more columns than shown, click more so that you can see all available columns. Click the sort icon to sort the list in alphabetical order to make it easier to find columns. Uncheck the select all so that it's easier to simply select the columns you need. We'll also select status and priority. When checked, this box adds a prefix to prevent duplicate names. I'm fairly certain there's no name conflicts, so I'm going to uncheck it. Click OK, and now you'll see these columns have resolved. Notice the ABC123 data type, so let's do detect data type again and watch it set these columns to text. Now we can click close and apply to execute the query against the list. To recap, there are three things to pay attention to when you're starting. First, do I need to filter anything? If so, add my filters. Second, have I set data types on all of my columns that I care about? Finally, do I need extended information? If so, expand Field Values as Text and select the desired columns. If we were finished, you would be ready to start creating reports against this data. Now I promised you that we would do this again using 2.0 implementation. So the big thing with version 2 is that it can either bring back all columns or whatever columns are present in the default list view. There's some data in the 1.0 implementation that's missing in the 2.0, like list item URL. For most common use cases, it can be used. I'd recommend testing both to ensure you have the necessary data. Now, let's begin with the 2.0 implementation so that you can see the differences. Go to Get Data. Enter Share to search. Select SharePoint Online List. Select 2.0. Under the Advanced link, you can select one of these two views. Let's select all. click OK. Now, because we are already logged into the site, it's not going to prompt us again. Select Issue Tracker and click Transform Data again. You'll notice the grid looks different. Where we saw table and record before, we now have a number of columns like modified by that have list in them. What we want is the name of the person who was assigned. Click the double-headed arrow in the top right. Select Expand to new rows. Notice the result is a record. Click to the right of the record to see the information in this record. In this case, we want the title because that's the person's name. Click OK. Lastly, let's select all columns and set the data type. Now click Close and Apply.
So hopefully you've got what you need to get started mining data out of your SharePoint list now with Power BI. This video was intended to be an introduction. It's really the first segment of a new and upcoming class that we have and how to mine data out of your SharePoint list and folders. If you like, click the link below in the description and get on the wait list. We should be releasing this class shortly.